Well, the story of the Greer family is about a whole lot more than one of loss and destruction. It's the story of how one close-knit community came together in a time of great need.
Just people just crawling out of the woodwork to be here for us. It's just completely amazing and awesome. And there's no words that I could possibly come up with. They don't exist.
While the devastation may be great, it's the helping hands of neighbors that have made it easier for the Greer family to cope with Saturday's loss of their home in Walker Valley. A fire the family says started in the kitchen spread quickly, ravaging the home built by owner Alan Greer 25 years ago. A family of five lived in the seven-room, two-story structure. Mrs. Greer and her nine-year-old son were at the house when the fire broke out just before 7 p.m. Another 13-year-old son was up the hill at his grandmother's.
When I just have a tendency to look out the window and look down at the house and I saw flames, I'm like, there's no way. I haven't been gone in 5 minutes. Just tossed on my boots, didn't tie them anything, and just ran down as fast as I could, lost the boots and everything.
But while the family did lose everything, including two cats that are still unaccounted for, they've seen the boundless generosity from the community, including much-needed money from a GoFundMe account set up by Ulster County legislator Craig Lopez.
I couldn't possibly dream of living in a better community. Hundreds of people have, you know, donated, and people we don't even know are bringing clothing and things for us. It's just incredible the way people come together.
The community, as always, has stepped up to the plate and is providing moral support, financial support, anything that the family needs to ensure that they're taken care of.
Right now, the Greers are staying with relatives nearby and are looking for a rental home before the long process of rebuilding. Through it all, they did manage to find some precious items among the rubble, such as pictures, coin collections, and heirlooms. And this, the flag that still stands and gives the family a glimmer of hope that everything will turn out right in the end.
We've toyed with the idea of moving over the years, but after all of this, I can't leave Pinebush.
For HVNN.com, I'm Paula Mitchell reporting.